Hello everyone, I am Dr. Neeraj and today's topic is artificial chromosome vector. So without any delay, let's move to the video. So first of all, what are artificial chromosomes? So these are just DNA molecules which are made in the lab and they behave like a normal, or you can behave like a natural chromosome. So these are the DNA molecule made in lab with the property of natural chromosome. So these are the artificial chromosome, because their name as itself indicating artificial, so they are not natural. They are made in the lab and they behave like the natural chromosome, so that's why these are called as artificial chromosomes. These may either be linear or they may be circular, and these are the example of these artificial chromosomes, like bacterial artificial chromosome, which is the BAC, yeast artificial chromosome, P1 derived artificial chromosome, and human artificial chromosome. So let's discuss them. First, bacterial artificial chromosome. So BAC, it is an engineered DNA molecule which is used to clone the DNA in the bacterial cell. Means this BAC, it can be used as a vector for the DNA cloning in the bacterial cell, and we insert our DNA sequence into this bacterial artificial chromosomes. Now bacteria, they just take up this BAC molecule, and as the bacteria grow, so this BAC also grows and our DNA of interest also multiply with this BAC. So in this way, this BAC can be act as a vector for the DNA cloning. Now the bacterial artificial chromosome vectors, means which are the vector based on this BAC. So this is the diagram of a typical BAC vector, and it contains, you can say, it is naturally derived from F plasmid, and it can take up to 1 MB of the DNA, and it contains 2 lambda cos N and P1 lox P sites. It also contains 2 cloning sites, that is HIND3 and BAM-H1 plus. It also contains certain other G plus C restriction sites like SFI1, NOT1, etc. And beside these sites is also have T7 and SP6 promoter for generating RNA probe. So this is the structure of a bacterial artificial chromosome vector. And there are some improved BAC vector like PBAC108L. And this was the first vector, and it lacks, or it do not have any selectable marker gene. We can just select this vector by using colony hybridization. But the improved version of this vector is PBALOBAC11. It is made from this PBAC108L, and it now contains the selectable marker gene, that is the LAC Z gene, which ultimately code for the enzyme beta galactosidase. And this gene can help the selection of host cell which contain this BAC vector. So these are the improved BAC vectors. Now, the next example of the artificial chromosome is yeast artificial chromosome. So it is artificially constructed chromosome, and it contains the telomeric sequence, centromeric sequence, replication origin sequence, and autonomous replicating sequences. So all these sequences, these are required for the replication of this yeast artificial chromosome vector. The first YAC vector developed was PYAC3. Now, what are the essential component for a YAC vector? So YAC vector, it contains first sequence is centromeric sequence, which is CEN4 sequence, and it is a sequence which is generally 125 base pair long. The next sequence, it is the ARS2 sequence, which is autonomously replicating sequence, and it is very much essential for the replication in the yeast cell. The next component of YAC vector is TEL sequence, which is the yeast telomeric sequence, and these are the sequences which are generally present at the ends of chromosome, and these sequences are also necessary for the replication and the maintenance of this YAC vector. Another component are the gene for selection in the yeast. So for the selection, it contains 2 genes. First is the URA3 genes, which is involved in the uracil biosynthesis, and another is the TRP1 gene, which is involved in the tryptophan biosynthesis. So both of these genes, they are utilized in the selection of this YAC, when we using the YAC vector in the yeast. And besides this, it also contain the bacterial origin of replication, because we can use this YAC vector in the bacteria also, when the bacteria serve as a host. So it also contains the bacterial replication of origin and selectable marker. So these are the essential component for a yeast artificial chromosome vectors. Now the next example of the artificial chromosome is PAC, that is P1 derived artificial chromosome vector. So it is a, you can say it have the feature of both P1 phage vector and bacterial artificial chromosomes, and it is that the temperate phage. P1 is a temperate phage which is used generally for the genetic analysis of E. coli. This P1 vector, it contains PAC site, that is the packaging site which is necessary for in vitro packaging of the phage. And beside this PAC vector, it also contains two LOXP sites. These LOXP sites, these are generally recognized by the Cre recombinase, and which are ultimately required for the circularization of this DNA when it is injected into the E. coli. So this PAC vector can be used for the construction of genomic libraries of mouse, human, drosophila, etc. Now next are human artificial chromosome. So these are artificially produced DNA molecule which serve as or which behave like a normal human chromosome. The HAC, it contain origin site which is necessary for the replication. It also have centromeric region, telomeric region and histone region. So this was all about the artificial chromosomes, that is bacterial artificial chromosome, yeast artificial chromosome, P1 derived artificial chromosomes and human artificial chromosome. So that's all for today, guys. See you in the next video. Thank you very much.